Question 18. Now, this one, my first inclination is to, oh, they got this formula here, this equation, this function. Let's just graph it and we can answer all of these. We probably could graphically get the answer because they do want it in the nearest hundredth. That would be one way. However, this is still in our format of amplitude is in front of the sign, right? This is going to give us our period. So, time for one complete revolution. They've just changed the language on us. One complete revolution is a period. We just have to figure out the period. We can do this the same way we've done everything. Frequency of h, we're going to get that. Now, there is this 20.9. There was a vertical shift upward on this function. You would see that if you graphed it, but there is no graphing function here on the calculator. Of course, if you had your own, you could do that. I know some of you do, some of you don't. You're supposed to, but we're not going to penalize you. So I'm going to show you this way. And again, maybe I'll come back and make a second one showing the graphical way for those who have a graphing calculator. I just don't have a graphing calculator on this computer. I'll have to do it on a different one. But let's lay this out. So what is this function really in terms of y equals a sine of b x minus c plus d. So I'm going to reorganize this. So 20.9 is our d. Okay, and that means we've got 18.4 sine. Our b is 1.4, and we don't have a phase shift. C is zero. So that's why they just put that x there. Okay, so that's what we got. This is h of t, the height. It's the y, right? We'll do it. And h of x, whatever. We could choose, variables, we can choose whatever letter they like to use t. So we can get the amplitude of h very readily. It's going to be the absolute value of 18.4. That's amplitude. That's the easy one. Nothing to do, it's just there. But the number of complete, the time for a complete revolution, that is a period, that we need to find. And we find that the period is equal to 2 pi over b. B is 1.4, so that's 2 pi over 1.4. And they want these in decimal form, so we can find that using our calculator. Let's see, 2 pi. Select it, divided by 1.4. It won't go any higher. I guess I have to go up. Oh, that goes up. That's straight. Okay, let me bring my window down a little bit. Over 1.4. Couldn't get to the decimal. Okay, equals nearest hundredth. So that 8 goes up to a 7. So 4.49. Rounding it up. And time is in, t is time in minutes. So that's, this wasn't seconds. So it takes 4.49 minutes for one revolution. So how many revolutions per minute? Well, not, it took 4 minutes to do one revolution. This is, and this one's sort of outside of the trig, but it takes 4.49 minutes to go one revolution. So how many revolutions will it do in only 1 minute? Well, that's sort of a conversion. It's going to be, it won't do a full revolution, right? So in 1 minute, we've got to divide. It's only going to do in 1 minute. It will only do 4.49 minutes of a revolution. So 1 minute, it'll do one of these. So yeah, so it took 2 minutes, right? Let's think of this. It took 2 minutes for a period, then in 1 minute, it would only do one half of a revolution. Okay, so this is going to give us 1 divided by 4.49. Oops, it's clear. 1 divided by 4.49. So 2.2222, and it only wants to the nearest hundredth, so 0.22. 22 revolutions per minute. It's just getting started, you know, about one, and that's about right, you know, if it took 4 minutes, that would be 1/4, which about, you know, 0.22. In 1 minute, you'll do about 1/4 of a revolution, okay? Amplitude, that's the easy part. We already got that, that's 18.4. Okay, we're making good progress. Now, you could have the zero here if you want it. And that'll be our answer for now.